Well, a new week has dawned, and strangely enough, all the snow that was here last Friday has melted. We had a wonderful warm weekend, and we're going to be making a couple demonstration runs of the J79 with afterburner. So we will be lighting the afterburner today. Hope to get some nice footage of that. And what we're doing here is we're running an engine that we have test run a couple times before. This is more of a demonstration run. We're essentially showing the capabilities of both the staff, us, and the test cell. The testing capabilities, all the data acquisition, and the fact that the test cell works as well as it does. So while you're watching this, I hope that you're hoping, as well as I'm hoping, that everything goes just fine, uneventfully, and everybody gets their job done professionally. So hopefully everything goes smoothly. This J79-19 is one of the higher output models, one of the later models of the engine. It's out of an ex-Italian Air Force F-104 Starfighter, and those were recently retired, sadly. You'll notice when we're running this engine, there's a considerable amount of black smoke in the exhaust, and that's due to relatively inefficient combustion. And the reason for that is this engine has the original fuel nozzles, and I've got two nozzles right here. The original fuel nozzle is right here, the shorter, stubbier one, and what they call the low smoke fuel nozzle. It's got a bit of a longer snout on it. It goes into a different combustor liner. The later combustor liner was designed to allow better mixing air in the primary combustion zone, and the main result of that was a little bit less vibration in the combustion chamber, so the liners lasted longer, and also less smoke. The lack of smoke is a big advantage, or it's less of a disadvantage, because when these engines were flying a lot in F4 Phantoms, particularly in Vietnam, they left a black line through the sky. Very easy to tell where the airplane was. And of the few accounts I've read of pilots flying in Vietnam with J79 engines, they didn't like having a big black line being drawn in the sky by their aircraft. It just made things too easy for the enemy. Anyway, this engine does have original combustors, and so that's where you'll see, that's the cause of the relatively large amounts of black smoke. It looks kind of cool on the camera, but it's a sign of inefficient combustion. Still, there's lots of power to be had. Well, out here by the fuel tank, I gotta say that run was a lot shorter than expected. Not a whole lot of afterburner footage, but some smoky full power footage and some views of the nozzle working. So hope that's enough to satisfy your afterburner appetite for a while. And once again, from the S&S test cell, thanks for watching.